So here we are on the Upland Backpacking Trail. We came to the first really nice lookout, which is sort of looking over through here. And you've got that to stand on to look out at the lake. But it's also grown up now, you can't see much. And there's Jenny ahead of me on the trail. She's got the big backpack on, I've got the little one, but when we put them on, we couldn't tell the difference in weight because all the water's on the little backpack. So this is the backpack that I'm carrying. This part of the trail is pretty easy. There was a few climbs, but we're not really getting challenged that much yet, but we know what's to come because we've already done this one before. This is the backyard we have to put up with. At about 6 in the evening, after dinner and a swim. So this is why we come to Algonquin, sitting by a steaming lake, eating oatmeal with craisins and bacon in it. Well, bacon if that's what you want. Cooked over a natural stick stove. Uses no fuel that we have to bring with us. Sun over there just behind the tree, illuminating all this. Yes, because this does it outside their lodge every day.
Yeah.
What is it, about 7 o'clock right now? That. So this is sitting on the shore of our campsite at East Provoking Lake. And there's one other campsite a little further down. We don't know if there's even anyone there, but theoretically it's booked. So there is the other end of the lake. That's the sunset. I'm trying to miss the sun. Our campfire is up top. It's just one of these campsites. It's a pile of rock. Clean, sunbaked. And you set up a tent in a secluded place. But there's our lake. Well, we're sharing this end with five others. Here's another view of the other end of our lake. East Provoking Lake. This is the end you come to when you take the long route back from the south end of the Highland Backpacking Trail. And then, well, I already showed in the other segment what you see at the other end, but this is the end that the sun is shining into. This is our dinner. We're just doing the final cook. So just get rid of some of the liquid, get it soaked in the food. That is our Firebox Nano. It's a special metal that's eaten the soot off of, and in it you put little tiny sticks, and the tiniest little sticks create a furious boil, as you can see here. So a campfire like this we don't use for cooking, it's for smoke to keep the mosquitoes away. We do our cooking this. And you can see the little hole. You put the little sticks in. You have to feed them fairly continuously. Only right now we're just about done, so there's not much more to feed. And then it keeps everything boiling. So Jenny's dishing up our dinner down by the lake. So you're looking into the sky and you're seeing Jenny dishing up food sitting on rocks in the lake. The trees on the horizon are upside down because you're seeing them in the lake. No, not that horizon. The horizon across the lake. We are at the lookout of Starling Lake. So Highway 60 is off in the distance. That's actually Mew Lake. And down here is Starling Lake. The Highland Backpacking Trail, which we're on, and we've come to a side trail that goes to this lookout. It loops around and finally comes out at the other end of that lake, and then goes up towards the highway where the cars park.